Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? If I'm honest with you, which I might as well be, I'm feeling a little bit stressed because I'm making some big decisions. I'm on the horns of a dilemma, making decisions about what software I'm going to be using to drive my business into the next level. It's a huge decision, and it's relevant to growing your YouTube channel to 100,000 subscribers because it's all about building community, finding ways to engage our community, and leveraging and making sure that we can make money from our efforts. So today on growing your YouTube channel to 100,000 subscribers, we're going to be talking about the software that drives the ship. I hope you enjoy it. One of the things which I think we all need to really pay attention to as we build our business in the online space is the tools that we use to engage and to manage our customers. Now, all of you aren't going to be in the exact same space as me. If we take a look at the business model that's been happening with Dotto Tech for the last 18 months as it's been evolving, I have re-engaged with my audience, kind of found my voice again, and started to build a marketplace by doing all of my how-to videos and surprisingly growing much larger, quicker in the States than in my native Canada, where I was already a known commodity. But nevertheless, that seems to be a bit of a happy surprise because in the States, they seem to be a little more willing to spend money on online products than they are in Canada. So it's been working out quite well. A big part of my business now the marketplace has led me to developing more online courses, which means I have customers that I have to start to service. When I started to build my YouTube channel, I was going with open eyes saying, what are going to be the opportunities for revenue? I wasn't going to lock on any one source. I would have preferred if I could have made enough money out of just AdSense revenue or possibly through Patreon support in order to carry the day. But that's not the case. At least it's not the case at this point. And so I was led to start to deliver information products. And the first one I delivered is my Evernote course, which is now, as of this point here, sold around 200 copies, which isn't a huge amount, but it's a good amount for my very first real solid information product. Now, an interesting thing happened to me. I woke up the other morning and I said, I've got nearly 200 customers, and the software that I'm managing those customers in is Aweber. Well, for those of you who don't know, Aweber is an autoresponder program. It's an email application which allows people to sign up so that I can send them newsletters or I can send them invitations to join my webinar. And Aweber is severely limited as far as what you can and can't do, because Aweber is basically an organization whose prime business objective is to stay in business and stay out of the spam cops' bad books. So they're so careful to make sure that none of their customers are spamming, are sending email which is illegal or not properly authorized. So they really limit what we can do with the software, and certainly doesn't give us very much flexibility. And I'll talk a little bit more on that in a few moments. But leading into that, it was a stark realization to me that I had done a good job of actually starting a new business, and now I had customers. But I didn't know who the heck those customers are, and I've got really no way of generating any sort of ongoing relationship with them, except, you know, through newsletters, just that sort of thing there. But not defining them, not being speaking to them individually, not parceling them out and finding out exactly a little bit more about them. So I was, I have to do something about this. So basically what I have been doing for the last several weeks is taking a step back and looking at what tools I need now to help grow the information product side of my business, where I have real customers who spend real money, take out their credit card, and actually purchase a product from me, and start to build that kind of a store interface and that customer management and customer relationship management interface. And oh my gosh, there are a ton of products out there that will serve us, but it really comes down to two main products that most of the information community looks at. The first is called Infusionsoft, and I'll just call them up here. Infusionsoft, there they are, and they are huge. And the other is called now Ontraport. They used to be called Office Autopilot, and so I'm going to call up Ontraport here too. Ontraport. There we go. And I'll call them up here as well. So these are the two main contenders in the marketplace. Now, I'll talk about them in a moment. But before I do, let me take you into where I'm coming from, which is Aweber. Now, Aweber is a very good contender in a class of software called email autoresponder. Its competitors are Constant Contact and Eye Contact, and probably I would say probably the best of the breed is one called MailChimp. So there's services where you can sign up, you purchase it's a monthly service that you pay for, and people can subscribe to your mail list on it, and it manages your mail list. And you can set up things like trickle campaigns where based on a series of rules you put in place, if somebody signs up for an email, then 2 days later you're going to send them another email, and 3 days after that you're going to send them another email. So you can trickle through information like that. I use it to deliver my courses, but I also use it to deliver my newsletter, and I use it to deliver information about my upcoming webinars and invites to my webinar. So I use it for a variety of different services. Now, I started Aweber about the same time as I started seriously working on the new YouTube channel, the enhanced YouTube channel. And the reason that I started it at that time was I recognized the fact that the strength of my business ultimately would be in my list. I knew at some point I would have to rely on being able to reach out to my community and make them an offer, asking them to view my videos, asking them to purchase a product from me. I didn't know what that offer was going to look like, but I knew I needed permission and I needed to establish a relationship. So what I was going to do is I was going to start producing a newsletter on an ongoing basis, which would cover off the type of content that we cover on the show and try and create some engagement, but basically get permission to send email to you or to the people who are interested in what I'm doing. So I started that now about 18 months ago, and I already had a mail list that was about 5,000 or 6,000. That was my mail list from back in the TV show day. But those were people that were fans of Dotto Tech, but weren't necessarily as interested in the productivity story that I was telling now, or the internet marketing story that you are part of here. So we started that, and right now I've built that in the last 18 months to about 6,500 subscribers. Is that a huge number? I don't know. Is it a terrible number? I don't think so. But again, I don't really have much frame of reference. I think it's an okay number. It's certainly a number that's now delivered me real paying customers, which I certainly appreciate. So this is now how I have to manage them, is in Aweber. Now, Aweber is severely limited, though. The bottom line is it's a great place to start because it's cheap to get into. It's free for the first 50 or 500 customers or something like that, and then it's $17 a month or $19 a month. And as you get more and more subscribers, they charge you more. Now, one of the things that I really don't like about Aweber, and one of the reasons that I'm not able to even stretch it out a little bit farther than I have at this point here, is the fact that these are all the different events that I started collecting email addresses on. When I did 3 steps to inbox zero, and when I did a webinar for the top 7 free apps, and my basic Dotto Tech news webinar. So these are all the different products or different events that people have signed up to my list based on. So I created new mail lists based on that because I had to send them a custom reply, and it was relating to when they were signing up for the mail list. And these are the number of people that subscribed in each one of those events. And some of them are quite large number, and some of them are quite a small number. But I don't really need all of these lists anymore. For instance, everybody that signed up for my 3 steps to inbox zero, they're interested in inbox zero. I would like to combine them all into a single list. Aweber won't let me. So that alone means that I'm managing multiple lists. And one of the things that drives me absolutely crazy about these guys at Aweber is they count each one of these subscribers as one, even though somebody might be on multiple lists. So when they're telling me that I actually have like 6,500 subscribers, but when I actually go and send an email out to everybody, I only have maybe 5,400. There's a good 1,000 subscribers that are on multiple lists, which is natural. This is going to happen because some people might be interested in different things that might be involved in a course that I'm taking, as well as on my newsletter list. So the bottom line is I don't believe I should be charged for people that are on multiple lists, because it doesn't take Aweber any more effort. It's just a just basically a tag attached to the email address. But this is a place that they're sort of nickel and diming us, and so consequently, it pushes you over the different thresholds. One of the big thresholds is the 5,000 user threshold, where you're, the how much you pay on Aweber jumps significantly. So they pushed me over that threshold, you know, at least 1,000 people before I really thought I should be. I don't really appreciate that, so I don't feel the warm and fuzzies for the Aweber folk. Technically speaking, it's a good service, delivers what it wants, not very much flexibility, and certainly they haven't thought their way through to my, the next level of business that I require, such as combining my lists and being able to migrate my people around. The reason that they do that, they say, is because they don't want me becoming a spam artist. They don't want somebody, me spamming people in sending emails to things that they haven't accepted. But they're not also allowing for good businessmen who will legitimately be combining lists that should be legitimately combined. MailChimp doesn't have these limitations. If I was to start again, I'd probably recommend you take a look at MailChimp. But regardless, you're still going to bump your head eventually into some of the other issues that I'm going to be talking about. So the bottom line for me now is Aweber is now an app that has seen its day with me and I need to move out of. I need more control. What do I need to be able to do? I need to be able to understand who signs up for my, who joins my community based on what product they're interested in. If they join me on a task and to-do list webinar, then they're more interested in task and to-do list manager. I should be able to identify that. If they purchase a product from me, I should be able to identify that. I should be able to do a search and say, who bought this course or who did, you know, who bought this course and attended this webinar, because they might be a certain group of people that I want to reach out to and offer something special to, maybe invite them to a Google Hangout or something like that. So I need to start to create this sort of control over the individuals that are on my mail list, because they are ultimately my customers. So all of those things that I just talked about are handled with a great deal of aplomb by these folks here at Infusionsoft and these folks here at Ontraport. Is that Infusionsoft or Infusion? What is this? I just got to make sure that I got the right... Oh, I got Infusion for some reason. I didn't even get to Infusionsoft. Infusionsoft. There we go. Infusionsoft.com. Let's go there. I don't even know who Infusion is. I wonder if they get a lot of people going to them by accident. There's Infusionsoft. That looks more like it. Okay. So these guys here at Infusionsoft or these guys here at Ontraport. Now, this is not a small step for a business like mine or probably like yours, because this is not $70 a month and not $60 a month. The pricing for Ontraport and Infusionsoft starts at about $200 or $300 a month. Is it $300? Yeah, $300 a month for their basic version here at Ontraport. Infusionsoft might have a tier that's slightly under, but you're not going to be spending less when you actually end up doing it. So all of a sudden you're going, gulp, there's an awful lot to this app, and I better be able to get an awful lot out of it, because $300 a month is a lot of money to be spending just on my mail list software, if I'm just using it for mail list, if you know what I mean. So it does more, though. To be fair, it does an awful lot more. A program like Ontraport or Infusionsoft will allow us to create landing pages, to register people for webinars, to create discount codes. They both have shopping carts where you can actually sell your product and control that. You can manage and protect content. It's sort of like a membership area where you can say, okay, if people have signed up for this course, we'll use the tools within Infusionsoft or within Ontraport in order to allow people access into those courses. Now, I've cobbled together pieces of software that do many of the same things, but these are completely integrated solutions. But in my mind, the most value that's going to come out of these solutions is the fact that I'm going to be able to identify all of the different engagements, all of the different types of engagement that I've had with each and every individual. So if I see a person's come to every one of my webinars, then I might indeed want to be able to invite them out to a special hangout just for my closest and, you know, the top fans of the Dotto Tech brand. So this gives me that ability using the software. Now, the onboarding of these applications is one of the things that is causing me a lot of consideration. Ontraport allows us to join for basically free And then they charge us $300 a month. They give you a money back guarantee. But to be honest, the money back guarantee doesn't matter in this case because you're going to be spending so much time setting up your system that your investment of money is far less than your investment of time and your resources in setting it up. Having said that, the folks at Infusionsoft want $2,000 to help me set up my business in their software, which I find a huge whack of dough for them to help me. But they include some training in that, that as well. To be fair, Ontraport includes training, 2 hours of training. They think it's supposed to be a little bit easier to use and a little bit easier to get your head around. But this is the decision that I'm going through right now. The purpose of this video is not really to tell you what I've chosen or to teach you, the best practices in this area, but it's to open your eyes to the decision-making process that you're going to have to make. I don't know that I should have made this earlier. I had people tell me that, back when I was starting, you should start with an Infusionsoft right away. But that would have been like a year ago and I would have spent like $4,000 or $5,000 in software at that point there. And I'm not sure that I would be that much farther ahead by now because I didn't have my whole business plan baked. Having said that, it would be nice not to have to face that right now when I've got momentum in so many other areas that I realize that every month that goes on where I don't embrace a much more advanced customer relationship management piece of software is a month that I'm losing opportunity. So now is the time that it has to happen. And I think we're all going to cross that river, with our business. We're going to hit that point where we cross this river. So I'm going to kind of leave this at that point there where I was saying, I'm going to tell you that this is the decision-making process that I'm going through right now. This is why I'm stressed right now because I think this is a big decision. I don't think. I know. This is a big decision because if I choose wrong, I might never know that I've chose wrong, to be fair. But if I do choose wrong, retracing these steps and redoing this again is going to be a lot of work. So I have to make sure that the piece of software that I choose and embrace that I can master and that I can really leverage because I'm going to be living in this software for a couple of years. That's for sure. I'm going to be using it and its capabilities are going to dictate the directions that my business can grow. That is a certainty to me. So I feel the weight of this decision at this particular point. So something to think about. Look forward to a couple months down the road. I will be telling you exactly what I've done in showing you the results. If you're just starting out and you don't want to, I don't think I made mistakes by signing up with Aweber. If I had the choice to do again, it wouldn't be my first choice. It's a good piece of software. It does exactly what it says. So I don't want to disparage it in any way. It's just rather rigid. And I think that MailChimp is probably a better choice from all of the things that I've looked at because it's a little less rigid, but it does all of the same things as Aweber. So if you're making that decision and you're just starting out, there's no problem starting with these other tools. Because ultimately you're going to be migrating upstream into a larger package at any rate. There, I hope that's been valuable. Remember, there's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. First of all, you should be subscribing to this channel. Secondly, you should be signing up for my newsletter in Aweber right now, but soon to be in something else. And finally, check out our Patreon page. Dotto Tech is supported by the community, which views us. There are perks to being patrons of Dotto Tech. I encourage you to stop by our Patreon page and take a look at that. So until next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle. Thank you.